Bless. Receive. To worship Him. It's going to be a sacrifice for you to sing. It's going to be a sacrifice for you to lift your hands. And even now you've been doing it. You've been lifting your hands, but it's been a sacrifice. You're going against what you feel. Because in the natural, you don't feel like lifting your hands. In the natural, you don't feel like praising. And I just feel like the Lord wants to remind somebody that to praise when it hurts is to praise when it counts. The sacrifice of praise is a praise that counts. That's the praise that matters. The song that you sing when you don't know what's going to happen tomorrow or next week or next month, and you don't know how ends are going to meet, and you're living in a posture of faith, and you don't know how the finances are going to come through, and you don't know how the body is going to be healed, and you don't know how that family member is going to receive salvation, and you don't see it in the natural. But when you tell your soul, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and let all that is within me bless His name," in the midst of that, in the midst of not understanding, in the midst of the questions, in the midst of the pain, in the midst of it, that's when He shows up. That's when you make room for Him to show who He is. When we bring ourselves low so that He can be lifted high. So when you praise when it's uncomfortable, when you sing a song that sometimes you may not even understand, you don't know how you're singing, and you don't know if you fully believe what you're even saying, that's when God will show up and He fills the gaps. I feel like tonight He's telling somebody, "I'm giving you grace for the gaps, for the places where you don't know what's going to happen, for the places where you don't understand, for the places where you are questioning. I am giving you grace for the gaps. My grace will cover the gaps. My Just let him reveal himself to you again.
Thank you.
Heavenly Father the way we've viewed our earthly fathers. And I just feel like the Lord wants to heal that. I feel like there are some people in this room and you've been let down by a parent. And you've been disappointed by a parent. And it's hard to picture how this God can be a good father because you only had bad experiences with father figures. But I feel like tonight he wants to reveal himself to you as your father. And I feel like the orphan spirit has to break tonight. Someone in here has been walking around like an orphan. You've been walking around as if you aren't a child of the king. You've been walking around expecting the worst to happen. But tonight the Lord is saying, no, it's time to expect the best because you are my child and you are an heir to my throne. As a child of the king, what belongs to the king rightfully belongs to you. You are an heir. You are a daughter. You are a son of the Most High King. Everything that heaven holds, you have access to. Everything that heaven has, you have access to as a son and a daughter. So as we sing, you're a good, good father, I just believe that those chains of an orphan spirit are going to break in this place. It's going to break in this place tonight. You're not going to walk around like an orphan any longer. You're going to know who you are. You are a son and a daughter. La 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 la.
We agree with your word.
Yes.
We agree with your word. Said we're the head and not the tail. We agree with your word. If you are for us, who can stand against? We agree with your word. We agree with your word. We agree with your words. Though the enemy comes in like a flood, oh, you raise the standard. When the enemy comes like a flood, oh, you raise the standard. Every time I've seen you raise the standard, every time the enemy came in, you raised the standard. You raised the standard. You raised the standard. So who are you, great mountain? Who are you, great? Who are you, great mountain?
Jesus, feed the darkness. He has never lost the battle. When we listen to the sound.
Yeah.
voice of the voices, you are. You are my
champion. Giants fall when you stand undefeated. Every battle you won, I am who you say I am. You crown me with confidence. I am seated in the heavenly place, undefeated. I believe. It is done.
It is done.
Oh, it is done.
we thank you that victory is a guarantee because it was bought on Calvary. Victory is our inheritance. It's in our name. We thank you that you already paid the price. We thank you that you met us here tonight. Who are we that you are mindful of us? Help us never make common what is precious. Your presence is precious. Access into the inner courts is precious. We thank you that you invite us from the outer courts into the inner courts. Who are we? We are unworthy to even tighten your sandal, God. We are not even worthy. Let us make us dwellers, God. We pray that you would make us sons and daughters who dwell in the inner courts, who know you, who know you, and who know how to access you. I pray that what you did tonight wouldn't just be an event, Lord, but I pray that this would be a posture that we carry, that from here on out, we would walk as children of the Most High, that we wouldn't walk in defeat, but we would walk in victory, knowing that you paid for it already. So it's guaranteed, no matter what it looks like, no matter what the circumstance may be, victory is a guarantee. So even if it doesn't look good right now, that means it's not over yet, because it's not over until you say so. And when you say so, that means it will be good, because you work all things together, not just some things, not just some seasons, not just some moments, but you work all things together for the good of those who are in love you and who are called according to your purpose, God. So we hide your promise in our hearts. We take hold of every promise that you've given us, God. And we thank you that it is done. We come in agreement. We set our hearts in agreement with heaven. We set our hearts in agreement with heaven. That it is done.